So I arrived in May. It was about 8 degrees. Temperatures, snow is starting to arrive, and we will be locked in by ice for the rest of this year, rest of my tour here. I work at Detachment 1. We work about 3.5 miles outside Thule Air Base.
At our separated unit, we are detached from our squadron and from the group and wing. Everyone here is assigned for 1 year, but just like in a deployed environment, you're away from your family. What we do at our site is we have 2 antennas, and we manage the personnel, the equipment, and the resources that enable these 2 antennas to communicate to satellites that are flying overhead. And what that communication does, it allows the satellite owners around the world to command and control their satellite programs.
It's imperative. It's the accountability piece. We are constantly updating home base with our position or where we may be headed next. It's immensely helpful. I mean, even back home stateside, I mean, we'll use them as a resource. They can send us weather from multiple destinations, multiple areas of the country, so that we know as we traverse through a different region what to expect. We can contact them airborne for real-time updates.
I would relate it to soccer. So we have the user, Team 1, and then we want to get that data, which is a soccer ball, to the satellite. We don't just kick it from the goal to the other goal. We have to make multiple passes in between to get it to that end user.
We support polar orbits, which are a subset of the low Earth orbiting satellites.
While other locations within the AFSCN can talk to the polar orbits, it's the frequency in which we talk to them that gives this location its importance. We have the ability to talk to them every 90 to 100 minutes.
And what that does, that enables whatever satellite mission to provide that space capability to the warfighter,